Let us take a simple portal frame, A, B, C, D, with all the spans of 6 meters each, columns and as well as beams, and it is subjected to a horizontal load at B, acting from left to right. So it is a definite problem of a sway case here. Of course, I have not taken any load on the members, just to see how it will work by stiffness approach also. How many degrees of freedom now? We know at A and D we don't get any degrees of freedom because both of them are fixed. Only possibility of degree of freedom is at B and as well as C. Since it is a rigid joint, it can rotate only. So it can rotate at B. The one of the degrees of freedom is rotation at B. The second is rotation at C. Since it is a sway problem now, there will be a sway occurring. That means BC will move to B dash C dash. Let me put it here. This will be your sway. Again, here also we are neglecting the axial deformation. So BC is exactly equal to B dash C dash. And of course, you will have rotations at B, at C, that is theta B, theta C. So you have 3 degrees of freedom, basically theta B, theta C, and we call it as a sway here, horizontal movement of the frame. Because bottom end is fixed here, there is a possibility of sway at the top end of the frame. So it is categorized as the problem is 3 degrees of freedom. Which are these 3 degrees here? You can put it here, theta B, theta C. To be specific, we can say it is sway. We assume that as delta. So therefore, your deformation matrix D will be equal to, you can give any number D1, D2 and D3, and particularly here what your D1 I would take it as theta B, D2 as theta C and D3 as sway. Since we got 3 deformations now, let us assume 3 coordinates for the given problem now. We need to put the directions also, so that using that direction as a reference, we have to put the values of the positive and negative here. So let us assume always clockwise, number 1 direction is direction of the rotation at B, number 2 direction of the rotation at C. Since we know clearly that it will sway, if at all it says it will sway towards right side, this will be number 3. So 3 directions of the coordinates here, our coordinate directions are direction of the coordinates, so we have deformation matrix is a vertical single column matrix here, and since you don't have any load on the members A, B, B, C and C, D, no lateral loads perpendicular to the axis of the member, so you don't get any fixed in moments. So therefore, I can put it as P1L, P2L, P3L are 0. In addition to that, you don't have any applied load here, this one. So only except this third portion, other things are 0. Again, P1 is 0, P2 is 0, whereas P3 is equal to 100. It is along the direction of the coordinate assumed is towards right. Load is also in the same direction, so it is positive value, so it is 100. Using these two, you can get the force matrix P. Now, again comes to the same step, it is formation of your stiffness matrix. K, how many degrees of freedom? 3 degrees, so N is equal to 3, so this will be 3 cross 3. So that means you have to find out 9 elements here. So there are 3 columns of the matrix, so 3 rows in each column. I need to find out that by using the approach as specified earlier for beams and as well as for the frame. The first step is to find out the first column elements. That you can find by giving unit rotation along the coordinate 1, wherein it means theta b equal to 1, theta c and delta should be equal to 0. So to represent this, see that all the joints are fixed first, then give a rotation in the clockwise direction. If you give a rotation in clockwise direction, this is the rotation theta b equal to 1, and at the same time, since it is a rigid joint, this member towards b to c, this also moves, both of them together theta b, that is equal to 1. And we have seen that to make it other deformations are 0, all the ends are fixed. I will do it in a different way. I will take out the free body diagram of this separately, so that I will mention everything on that one. You can directly copy that to find out the coefficients. So this is near end now. 4 into EI divided by L is 6, and the far end, this will be 2EI by 6. Both of them are clockwise, so the reaction induced at B and C in the horizontal direction, it will be from right to left, so that it should produce anti-clockwise moment to counteract the acting moments of 4 EI by L and 4 EI by L. This will be equal to, we have derived the equation, it is 4 plus 4. 4 plus 2 is 6 EI by L divided by span L is 6 meters. It is 6 EI divided by L is 6 square. It is equal to EI by 6. Once you get this reaction, there will be a reaction opposite at this point A. Of course, we don't use that for calculation. To maintain the equilibrium, we need to mention on the figure. So you have a contribution to the first component is this. Second will not come here, and the third one will come here. This is first and this is the third one. And coming to horizontal member BC now, again this also rotates at B through an amount equal to 1. This rotation occurs here at B, because of that you will get a near end moment. It is also 4 EI by L is 6, that is equal to 2 EI by 3, and this end it is 2 EI by 6. It is EI by 3. And of course, because of this, you will get a vertical reaction here downwards, and here it is upward. These two are clockwise. If we take moment about B, this should produce anti-clockwise, and this is equal to 6 EI by L square is 6 square. That is same as your EI by 6, and this one also EI by 6. So you have the components here, and this value will contribute to your coordinate 1, and this value will contribute to your coordinate 2. There will be no contribution for the horizontal reaction from the member BC. So your K11 now. By now it is, you know what is this actually. It is force developed at coordinate 1 due to unit rotation along the coordinate 1. So it is nothing but your components of 1 and 1 here. So it is equal to 4 EI by 6 from BA plus 4 EI by 6 from BC. Together here it will be equal to 8 EI by 6, that is nothing but equal to 4 EI divided by 3. K K21. K21 is second coordinate C here, that is rotation at C, that is nothing but your 2A by 6, that is equal to only one value of contribution here, because other end is vertical member, it is not rotating here, so that is equal to EI by 3. And if you take the third coordinate is K31, because of the force developed. Now here the force developed. These two, in general term force we say, whereas these two are moments and this one is actually the force. The load is developed here, reaction, that is EI by 6. Observe the direction of EI by 6, it is acting from right to left, whereas our assumed coordinate direction is from left to right. So I have to take it as minus now, minus EI divided by 6. So the first three elements of the first column, 4EI by 3, EI by 3 and minus EI by 6. Let me take these three, you will put it here. I will put K equal to, it is 4EI by 3, EI by 3, EI by 6. Let us move to the second step to find out the elements of the second column of the stiffness matrix. The same thing here. Number 2, unit rotation along the coordinate 2, it means theta C equal to 1, whereas theta B and the sway is 0. So the representation in the figure A, B, C, D. So to maintain the conditions now, if you rotate in the clockwise direction, theta C equal to 1. If you rotate this way here, the same figure now, I will put it the free body diagram of BC. Because of this rotation in the member BC, there will be a clockwise moment developed here. It is always equal to 4EI by L. L is 6. This is 2EI by 6. And of course, at this point, again a clockwise moment of 2EI by 6. And if you take the vertical member here, again it is also a clockwise moment, 4EI by 6. And here it is 2EI by 6. And because of the clockwise moments here, so there will be a reaction developed towards left side at C. If you take moment about D here, you should get a clockwise moment due to applied developed moment here, and the reaction should act towards left side, and this reaction is sum of these 2 by 6. It is equation we have derived, it is 6EI by L square is 6 square, that is nothing but equal to EI by 6. This will contribute to your coordinate 1, these 2 will contribute to your coordinate 2, and this will contribute to your coordinate 3. So K12, it is the moment developed at coordinate 1 due to unit rotation given along 2 now. This is the value, it is 2EI by 6, and it is equal to EI by 3. You can check what is the value of K21 here, it is EI by 3, and here also it is EI by 3. It is equal to same, because symmetric matrix use your stiffness 1. And K22, it is the moment developed at coordinate 2 due to these 2 now, so CB and CD, It is both of them are same, 4EI by 6 plus 4EI by 6. It is 8EI by 6. So it is 4EI by 3. And the next one, K32, the reaction developed in the horizontal direction in this member here. You don't get any vertical horizontal here. The same thing will come here in the right direction. You want to transfer this to this horizontal member here. This is two are same here, and opposite to that is this though. So this value now here, it is equal to EI by 6. And with plus or minus, look at the direction developed is towards left side. Our direction is towards right side. So again, the value is minus EI by 6. So we got the next column, three elements here. K12 is equal to K21 EI by 3, you can see here. And K22 is same, 4EI by 3. And this is minus EI by 6. So we got the second column elements also of the stiffness matrix. Let me move to the next step now to find the elements of the third column of the stiffness matrix. What we have to do now here, now it is different now. The third coordinate is an axial force you have to develop. So because of this force, there will be a deformation. That means we say displacement of the member BC to B dash C dash. So here, third step, give unit displacement along the coordinate 3. So this means here delta equal to 1, theta B and theta C are 0. So to represent this here, A, B, C, D. Let me take some unit value of delta. Once you move B, C also should move by the same amount. Why? Because you don't have any horizontal movement. By simple thing, I will represent this now. So, we have to see that all the joints are fixed, your theta C is 0, theta B is also 0. So for this condition, we need to find out the forces induced at all the members. So let me take the vertical member AB first. It has moved through an amount that is equal to delta equal to 1. The moment developed because of this at the ends will be equal to 6 EI divided by L square is 6 square, and the same amount will come here also, 6 EI divided by L square. It is the sway problem or sinking of support. If you take left to right, if right support sinks by an amount, so the what we get, the moment developed at both the ends remain same. It is minus 6 EI delta by L square. Now delta equal to 1, so it is 6 EI divided by L square. And with respect to A, B moves downwards. If you put it in the horizontal direction, you can observe clearly it moves in the downward direction. So because of this now, I need to find out the reaction developed. Now the reaction developed is towards right side. Why? I have an anticlockwise movement developed because of the sinking here or the movement of the support B to B dash. So you will get a clockwise at the right side force here. How much it is? The sum of these two divided by L, it is actually equal to 12 EI divided by L cube. So that was the equation which we have derived in the beginning of this chapter. 12 EI by L cube, so 12 EI by 6 cube, and of course to compensate this, there will be reaction at the bottom of same magnitude, 12 EI by 6 cube. And same way you have to write for CD also, again here also, C moves to C dash, and you will get same amount of moment developed as similar to AB, 6EI by L square in the anticlockwise direction, and you will get, because of these moments induced here, you will get a reaction here, 12EI divided by 6 cube, and of course opposite to that, 12EI by 6 cube. You don't get anything from the member BC. So member BC will move to B dash, C dash. So no rotation in this case, because we have seen here joints B and C are rigidly fixed not to rotate. So theta B is 0, theta C is 0. So you don't get anything component for this contribution here from these two members. So let me write it here. The values now, K13, moment developed now, I have this value 1, and this contribution is 2, and these two will have a contribution for third coordinate. So only for one value, that is nothing but the moment developed in the member BA, that is MBA is minus, so it is minus 6EI by L square is 6 square, 6 gets cancels, it is equal to minus EI by 6. You can observe the matrix what we have written here, the first column, third element, it is K31 is same as K13, so it satisfies our principle of your stiffness matrix. Let me move to the next element, K23, that is this component now, again anticlockwise, minus 6 EI by L square is 6 square, 6 gets cancels, minus EI by 6. You can observe the second column, last one, it is also minus, so it is equal to K32. So matrix principle simplified now, that is solved, and the last one here, K33, it is the sum of these two reactions, 12EI by 6 cube and 12EI by 6 cube. Incidentally, both of them are acting towards right side. We have said in the beginning of the stiffness matrix solution, all your leading diagonals should be always positive. What we assume here, clockwise or anticlockwise, it is positive. Since the direction of 3 is towards right, I am getting reactions towards right side only. 12EI by 6 cube plus 12EI by 6 cube. 12EI divided by 6 cube plus 12EI divided by 6 cube. So it is equal to now, it comes to around EI by 9. So I can transfer them all the values here. This is already available here. Still I am transferring from that, minus EI by 6, minus EI by 6, plus EI by 9. See, observe these three diagonals should be always positive. If it is getting negative, means there will be some mistake in your calculus. So we got the stiffness matrix. All the values are transferred to the matrix. It is 4EI by 3, EI by 3 and minus EI by 6, EI by 3, 4EI by 3, minus EI by 6, minus EI by 6, minus EI by 6 and EI by 9. So once you have these values, let me use stiffness relation now. It is P is equal to K into D. Since P matrix you have to calculate, P1 minus P1L, P2 minus P2L, P3 minus P3L, this comprises the force matrix. P1, P2, P3 are the induced forces or moments on the problem, and P1L, P2L, P3L is the induced or the developed moments or reactions along the coordinates due to applied load on the members. And this is your K11, K21, K31, K12, K22, K32, K13, K K23, K33, and of course you have D1, D2 and D3. P1 we have said it is 100 minus 0, 0 minus 0, 0 minus 0. Let me take out EI outside. It is 4 by 3, 1 by 3, minus 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 4 by 3, minus 1 by 6, minus 1 by 6, minus 1 by 6, minus 1 by 9, multiplied by D1, D2 and D3. It's a column matrix. So therefore, EI D1, EI D2, EI D3, let me take this to find out the deformations transferred to the left hand side along with EI. Invert the matrix multiplied by 100, 0 and 0, another column matrix. On solving that, inverting and multiplying them, small correction here, your P3 is 100, not P1. P1 and P2 are, there's no force is developed or applied here, only P3 is applied, that is 100 here, and so it is 0 and 100. With these corrections now, because P3 is 100, remaining all of them are 0, so on solving we get the answers are EI D1 is equal to 128.571, EI D2 minus 128.571, EI delta, that is the lateral movement or the sway, and all three are plus only, sorry. So what we have assumed in the beginning, we'll put it here, EI theta B, EI theta C, EI, this is D3, finally you can put it as EI delta. So all the values we got, incidentally all of them are same because we don't have any load applied on this member. Using these deformations, theta B, theta C, of course theta A and D are 0, and the lateral movement of the frame sway, you can find out the final moments. Let me write the values now. Using your basic slope deflection equation, I'll put it here for your clarity. MFAB plus 2EI by L, 2 times of theta A near end plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. So MAB first time is 0 plus 2 by L is 6. I'll take out EI inside, EI theta A is 0 plus 2 times of 128.571 and minus 3 into 2, 6 times 128.571. So it is 171.42 with minus. Kilonewton meter. MBA again vertical member, MFB is 0 plus 2EI by L, 2 by 6, since EI I am taking inside, theta A is 0 again plus 2 times of, sorry, this is not 2 times, sorry, 2 is there is 2 into 8, 2 by 6, okay. 2 times theta A plus theta B, yes. And here it is 2 times theta B minus 6 into 128.571. This is same value, minus 128.57. Of course, kilonewton meter. MBC 0 plus 2EI by 6, 2 times of theta B, 128.571 with 2, minus theta C, 128.571. So 2 plus 1, 3, 3, 3, so it is again plus 128.571 kilonewton. You don't get the lateral movement for the horizontal member BC. BC is horizontal, no movement in the vertical direction, so delta is 0 here. MCB, 0 plus 2 by 6. Theta B is 128.571 plus 2 times of theta B, C is 128.571. MCD is vertical member, again 2EI by L is 6, EI taken inside, 2 times of theta C, 128.571 minus, so we need to correct the equation, answers are correct, so this should be 2 actually. On solving your stiffness relation, you will get the values of EI theta B, that is D1. As 128.571, EI D2, that is theta C, is 128.571, and whereas EI delta is again plus value 1285.71. So using these two rotations and one sway value, you can calculate the final moments. MFAB is 0, 2 by 6, 2 times of theta A is 0, plus 128.571 minus 3 by 6 is half into 1285.71 is equal to minus 171.42. On the same lines, MBA is MFBA 0, 2 by 6, theta A is 0, 2 times of theta B is 128.571 and minus half of 1285.57. So it is, answer is minus 128.57. So coming to MBC, you don't get the sway component here because it is a horizontal member, 2 by 6, 2 times of 128.571 and theta C is 128.571, the answer is 128. And MCB, again horizontal member, no sway, 2 by 6, 128.571, 2 times of theta C, the answer is 128.571. And MCD, MFCD is 0, 2 by 6, 2 times of theta C, minus 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2 into EI delta, it is 128.571. The answer is minus 128.571 kilonewton meter. And the last one, MDC equal to, MFD is 0, 2 by 6, theta C is 128.571 plus theta D is 0, minus 3 by 6 is half, 1285.71, the answer is minus 171.42 kilonewton. So you just transfer them onto the frame minus 171.42 minus 128.57 plus 128.57 plus 128.57 minus 128.57 minus 171.4. All of them are in kilonewton meter. With these final moments, you can use them to sketch or draw the required diagram of bending moment and shear force diagrams, and also you can draw the elastic curve. Thank you.